everybody. It's been Annalise, and I just want to give a huge thanks to my best friend, Brie. She wrote this incredible story. It covers so many heavy topics, and it's so beautifully done. And she wrote all of this in a very short amount of time, and it's so good. And I made her voice act in this because I really wanted to do this with her. And I think it ended up really well. I hope you all enjoy it. Please give a big thanks to her. But anyway, please enjoy. Also, this took a lot of time to coordinate and edit, so keep that in mind when you think about how much you like it. You were everything to me. Tall, hair white as a cold winter storm. You loved to dress in black, even if it didn't really match your persona you portrayed. You were kind, and you held me throughout the night. Everything was perfect until you decided to leave me. I still don't understand why, or why you didn't leave some type of goodbye. It was my first day back since the incident. People stared. Most asked if I was okay. How the hell do you respond to that? Yeah, I'm doing great, other than the fact that my boyfriend just killed himself without even leaving a note less than a month ago. I got to my first period, and this girl was just crying, saying how much she loved him and how sad she was. She didn't even know him, like I did. I didn't know what went over me, but I just ran out. I walked through the empty hall, and I saw that damn picture in the glass case. I fell into a corner in a ball and just cried. I can switch emotions pretty fast. I'm good at hiding emotions. Good at switching. I guess he was, too. Dallas was the type of guy everyone loved. He was envied. People looked up to him. He was an athlete, a good son and friend. He seemed perfect, like a perfect story. But a perfect story doesn't exist. It's just the truth. Just sitting there in this empty hallway, I don't know how long it's been. I guess long enough for my best friend to come looking for me. She sees me and she sits by me, her eyes red. I could tell she was crying. I asked her, why, Elle? I don't get it. Why do people have to leave? Why didn't he tell me? I could have stopped him.
Stop. There was no way he would have known. Just know he stuck around for as long as he could. For you. I should know. He was one of my best friends.
So he sat under that glass case where that picture stayed with his white hair and warm blue eyes. He was smiling so big. That smile had so many secrets. We sat there for what seemed like forever. Me and Elle have been friends since 7th grade. We met at recess when she punched a kid for making fun of me. I always admired her. We did everything together. She even became really close with Dallas, so it was also really hard on her. It scared me, considering she uses humor to cope with everything, even when she got diagnosed with severe anxiety and depression. Or when her brother went to jail. She hasn't seen him in years. But this time, she didn't use jokes to defend herself or even hide her tears. As I walk back home, my dark brown hair flows into my eyes, while purple streaks from my hair fill my vision. I take a look at all the trees and leaves falling. It was cloudy. Not usually how fall is down here. I ended up walking past my home. I just kept going. I stopped when I got to the cemetery. I walked to his grave and sat there for a while. None of it really hitting me yet. I felt bad for not crying, for not feeling anything at all. I was 16 and I didn't have a car, so I walked home every day. I used to get a ride with Dallas, but after he died, I spent most days walking aimlessly through the neighborhood, not to look at that place when I walked past. I got inside and ignored my mother as she asked how my day was. I got to my room, went to the mirror, and stared at myself for a while. I thought, maybe he did it all because of me. Because I was too much, because I was too dark, and not trusting enough. If I went over that night when he said, I want you to know I love you, I always will. But instead I went back to sleep. I wasn't there for him. I will never forgive myself. A month passes and I learn to drown my pain with alcohol and sneaking out every night, with Elle roaming the city in her brand new car while she blasted music, made fun of the people walking by while I drank in the passenger seat, and pretended I was doing just fine and that I was getting better. But I missed him so much to the point it physically aches. But no one can know, because I can't be in the hospital again. I started to fall asleep in the car while Mr. Brightside blasted at full volume.
Hey, bitch, get the fuck up. I ain't fucking shit up myself,
Elle said, her blonde hair flowing in the wind, and bright blue eyes that filled so much emotion. She was honestly beautiful. She had every guy right at her feet. Fuck off, I said with a grin. She smiled and put her arm around me and yelled,
tonight is our night, Jazz.
She said that every night, hoping one night it would be true. We ran around the empty road and screamed till our throats burned. She danced to the music and sung at the top of her lungs, grabbing my hand and making me dance with her. We were smiling and laughing. We lay down and stared at the stars while she was making jokes. And then I thought of him again. We used to lay in the road at 3 a.m., just talking. I would look into his eyes and feel mesmerized. I thought this would last forever, just me and him. Now here I am, laying in the road, but without him, just me and Elle, and a beer in one hand. I look at her, and she looks at me. I start to think about how beautiful she is, and how her eyes look under the city lights, and how her blonde hair frames her perfect face. I start to think about the first time I realized I loved Dallas. We were here in his car one night. We were driving back from Elle's party. We stopped at the beach. We lay down on the sand, looking up at the stars. He said, race you, and took off his shirt and ran into the water. I ran after him, laughing. He held my hand as we got into the water. The small waves were rippling over us, and the moonlight hitting the water made a reflection that was as beautiful as the stars above us. He held me, and we stared into each other's souls. I watched as his pupils got bigger and smiled. I was right where I was supposed to be. His long, white blonde hair was wet and dripping water down his face, and he pushed his hair back and smirked at me and pulled me in and kissed me. This is when I knew I'd fallen, and fallen hard. Now I'm not the perfect girl I was. School's out, and I'm looking into this girl's eyes. City lights all around us. Something inside me feels free for once, like I can breathe again. My thoughts get interrupted as she sits up laughing, taking the beer out of my hand. She stands up, takes a swig, and spins around, flipping off every car that drives by and just laughing. She's more drunk than I am. But then again, she's drunk even when she's sober. She gets drunk on just pure life. She drives me back to my house. I sneak in through my window. I know deep down this night will always be more than just a memory to me.
After I dropped Jazz off, I drove to my boyfriend Cole's house. I have a key, so I just walked in. I'm 17 and he's 18. He lives alone in a little house close to his parents. I walk down the hall to his room. He yells at me to tell him where I've been. I tell him I've been with Jazz, but he doesn't believe me. We fought for a while. I've just been wondering what I did wrong. Finally pulls me in and says he's sorry for not believing me. I tell him I need to get home, and he smiles. He says, that's fine. As I walk away, he pulls me by my wrist and turns me around, gripping me by my wrist. He keeps asking why I lied straight to his face. I try to get away as I push and push. I start to get panicky and I can't breathe. He looks at me in the eye and grabs my face and yells, calling me a whore, telling me to tell him where I've been. I don't say anything, and he hits me. I fell to the ground. I get up and I try to run away, but he chases after me, telling me how sorry he is, and how he loves me and he can't lose me. He has never hit me before, just threatens to. With tears streaming down my face, I forgave him. I thought it was the first and last time.
Usually on my way home, I avoid Dallas's house. I just can't handle it. This time, I decided to face it. On my way home from work, I pass this house, and I stop and look. Next thing I know, I'm knocking on his door. His mom opens the door, telling me how happy she is to see me, and how I should come in. She tells me I can go up to his room, so I do. When I open the door, I smell him. Nothing changed. It's like he's still there. I lay on his bed, remembering him holding me. I look over and see the picture we took. He's holding my waist, and my hands are around his neck. He's looking down at me, and I'm smiling while looking in his eyes. I look through his clothes and decide to take his young blood one that still smells like him. I look through his nightstand drawer. I see a journal, and it's his. So I decided to read through it. It starts out about us, about the moment we first said I love you. He writes about how much he cares about me, and how happy I make him. He tells about Elle too, how he loves her. As I read through, the smile on my face fades as I get to one titled, Mom. Apparently his mom got really drunk one night and came home and started telling him to hang out with her. He talks about how this wasn't the first time, so he said no. She didn't exactly take that well. She begged and he kept saying no. She got in his face and started reaching down. He pushed her, yelled, and tried to get out. She pushed him down on the bed and went from there. He felt disgusted. It all started again. The last entry is talking about how he can't do it anymore, and the only thing keeping him going is my eyes. And at the end, he says, "Jazz, I know you will find this one day. Just know, I said I will love you till the day I die that night. And I have." It's been a few months since I found Dallas's journal. I took the journal with me that day and turned it into the police. His mom's been arrested, so she can no longer hurt anyone. I just wish I knew before he did it. Maybe then I could have done something. I was now in my junior year of high school at this time. Things changed. I finally had my own car. I got a small Jeep for my birthday. It ran pretty well. The purple streaks in my hair were gone. I changed it to blonde. I was doing a lot better. I had a job at a little hippie store called Peace and Love. Felt like I was finally getting my shit together. Oh, wasn't exactly doing the best. She acted like she had it all together, but she was out basically every night at parties, getting drunk or high. She had never touched a cigarette before, but she started smoking pack every day. She had underbag eyes and stopped wearing makeup. She looked like she hadn't slept in days. I tried my best to hang out with her after work, every night to keep her in check. She always said this was her year and she was having the time of her life, but I could see through that lie. She was with Cole during the day. She would skip school just to hang out with him. I didn't understand this. She never did this before. Not even after Dallas died. She wasn't the same. I don't understand why this bothered me so much. I mean, it's her life. Why did I care so much about it?
I was done. I was fucking done. I hung out with Cole all day, every day, and skipped school most days just to hang out with him. He made me quit my job just because I was the only girl. He would get pissed at me the days I didn't hang out with him. Or he'd get pissed at me for anything. At night, I would go to parties with Jazz and just try to forget everything. I had to wear long sleeves to cover up the bruises he caused every time he got mad at me. Sometimes he caused a black eye that I would have to cover up. It's exhausting. I didn't feel like me or like anything like myself but his. I was scared constantly, even at my own house. The only time I felt okay and safe was when I was with Jazz. I didn't understand why, but I would just forget everything when I was with her. At this point, I was so tired of living, but I couldn't leave Jazz, not after everything she's been through. It started off as just yelling and mental abuse and physical abuse. I could handle that. I learned to handle a lot at a young age. I watched my brother go down a bad path, and he would come to me crying every night. I would hold him and tell him everything was all right. I saw too much way too young. But then it turned into more than I could handle. I got home one night around 3 a.m. and headed to my room. I gasped as I saw Cole in my bed. "What the hell, Cole? Why are you here?" He got up and grabbed my hand, pulling me on the bed. "Come on, Cole, stop. I'm not in the mood." I started pulling my shirt off and kept yelling at him, and he wouldn't stop. Next thing I knew, he was over top of me, and I couldn't move or breathe. "Cole, stop." I said, "I'm not in the fucking mood. Get the fuck off me." He didn't say anything until he whispered in my ear, "Shh, sweetheart. Just let it happen. You'll enjoy it." I just lay there in silence, almost in tears. I stopped fighting. When he left, I cried. I let it all out. I started panicking. I couldn't breathe. My chest hurt. My head was pounding. I couldn't talk. I felt like I was dying. And the only words I could make out were, take me away.
Jazz called me in tears that night, saying she needed to get out and meet her at the Attractor Motel. I drove over there and saw her truck in the parking lot. I ran to her and hugged her while she was in tears. She told me everything. It took a lot, but I convinced her to break up with him, and that I would be right there with her. We decided to sneak out into the pool and go swimming. We hopped the fence. We got in the water. About an hour passed and Harry Styles was blasting. She came up from the water and pushed her wet blonde hair back. She looked beautiful under the night sky under the moonlight, blue eyes sparkling. She looked happy and content for once. I haven't seen her like this in so long. It was nice. My thoughts got interrupted when I opened my eyes to see Elle in front of me. She was smiling. She didn't say anything. She just pushes my hair back and leans in. God, she's beautiful. I don't understand any of this. But then everything stopped once we heard the security guards yelling. We made a run for it, laughing and smiling. In this moment, I felt truly alive. We were holding hands while running. When we were clear from security, we danced under the stars, jumping and yelling. This is the moment of our lives. When driving home, I realized everything I didn't understand. I understood now. Well, shit. I'm in love with Ellie Moon.
That night I called Jazz. We met at the Attractor Motel. We went swimming.
I was just swimming and I was just chilling to music. With her, I felt content, maybe even happy.
For the first time in a long time,
I look up and I see Jazz with her eyes closed. She looks so pretty with her icy blonde hair. She's just so fucking beautiful. She has crazy green eyes. She's pale with freckles. I can stare into her eyes forever. I realized then why I was so jealous of them and how much they hung out. Not because I wanted to hang out with her like best friends did, but since that moment, I punched that kid for her. I loved her. I loved what I couldn't have. I looked at her and got closer. She opened her eyes and smiled. This was the moment I started to lean in, and that was when we heard the yelling. And that night I realized I was hella gay.
The next day I went to Elle's house. I walked in and heard her screaming for help. I ran upstairs as fast as I could. The door was locked. I took my car down and unlocked the door. When I got in her room, I saw Elle on the floor with Cole on top of her, hitting her, saying over and over again, "You can't leave me. This is what happens when you try to." I felt anger in me. I ran in and pushed him off. The next thing I know, I'm on top of him, punching him over and over again, screaming. Never seen myself like this before. This is what I needed to do. Elle pulled me off of him, saying the police were coming, that we had to leave. So I ran out the door and ran outside. It was pouring. She was laughing like crazy. She had bruises all over her face. I didn't understand why she was laughing. I kept asking her why she was fucking laughing. Next thing I know, she's pulling me in and kissing me. I could feel her smiling with her lips against mine. When we pulled away, I said we should probably get an umbrella.
We don't need a damn umbrella. Just kiss me.
So we did. All right, that was it, my peeps. I really hope you enjoyed that. Again, this did take a lot of time to make. But anyways, I hope your day or evening is going great. I love you all. Bye!